Hey guys, it's Monday and I've got something special to show ya. And come on and let me know you're there. Say hi. And I'm just sharing real quick before we get started. Got a couple things here. I got a bunch of new products that I'm gonna use today. And I also wanted to show you my hair growth from the Garlic Pixel Shampoo. And let me know how you're doing. It's Monday. It's an amazing day. The sun is kind of shining here in the Northwest. So let me just go ahead and share alike here. Okay, go. And I'm gonna go ahead and put my link in case anybody wants to look at any of these new products here. Say hi and let me know how you're doing. Again, I've got something to show ya. And I got lots of new things, but there's way too much to show you at this time. But I'm going to use some new products. Some amazing, amazing, amazing new products. So, hang on one moment there. I am a little bit jittery today. I decided I was going to take a NAT, which is like a ketone, and it has caffeine in it, and then I'm lightheaded because I've had a headache. So yeah, so this is gonna be interesting, but we're gonna get through it. I'm just a little bit ditzy. I feel ditzy, so what's new? So how we doing? Let me know how you're doing. Say hi, give me some hearts. And we're gonna start in just a sec there. We always have trouble with this darn technology. Technology. Let me fix myself here and look a mess. Didn't fix my cardigan here. I just kind of threw it on. Thought it was kind of cool because I'm gonna use purple lipstick today. So that's why I put this color on. I thought, yeah, all right, awesome. We're gonna check out the 24 karat gold glam lipstick. There's three colors and I wore the red on Thursday, the last time I went live. Today I'm gonna wear the purple and of course I'm gonna show it to you. So one moment there. I'm just gonna log into my site here, and I'm cooking too. Caffeine, dang. It's a good thing, but I'm on a diet, and so I've lost 26 pounds already. So I don't get my Starbucks because I'm on a diet, because I love Starbucks. But we'll just have to, you know, go with the flow. Starbucks has a good nitro. Alexa, volume 2. Starbucks has a good nitro product. It's a coffee. It's like a cold. Somehow they make this special coffee. It actually tastes pretty good. I can have that with like sugar-free vanilla. So, yum, yum, yum. All right, I found what I needed here. And I'm just gonna go ahead and paste my link. And I'm cooking. Woo! Dying. So let me know if you're there. Let me know if you're watching. Give me some love. Again, I got new product. I can't wait to show it. I can't wait to see what the look is gonna be today. We've got a new look. And my theme is purple. So amazing, amazing. And again, I'm just gonna go ahead and paste my link here and wait for a minute until people come on. And here we go. Okay. Alrighty, so first of all, before I start with my makeup, I'm going to show you what this garlic Capixel, it is garlic, it's Dr. Tuna's garlic and Capixel line, and I use the shampoo and the mask. Again, amazing. I've been using it since like January, and so I just got my hair done a couple weeks ago, and my hairdresser was able to pull in the hair growth into the highlights, into the foils, because it was that long. And now you can really see. You couldn't really see. I knew they were there. I knew I had hair growth there, but I couldn't really show you because it was my ash brown color. So, but now I'm going to show you what this line has done for me. I have thin hair. And it's fragile because it's so thin. So when I use heat, like what killed my hair one time was the flat iron. So I cannot use the flat iron because then I just love the look and I use it all the time. And then I end up just burning my hair off. I had some hair loss up here because of the heat over the years. And so this is what the garlic Capixel line has done. Let's see, I'm gonna kind of pull that down because you can see this is all new hair, and it was long enough to go into my highlights this time, so I'm able to show you that this is again my result. And here we go, I'm gonna pull more out on this side. I don't know what the rest of my head looks like because I can't see, but this is magic. So this is, you know, the garlic helps to clear the bacteria off of your scalp. And you know, again, there's bacteria are good, but yet they're bad. So again, they can cause inflammation in your hair follicle and you know, and stun growth, and even you can have balding. The Capixel is red clover. Again, it's a natural ingredient that also helps promote growth. So this stuff's amazing. I got it. My proof is there. I mean, I just showed it to you. Amazing. So if you want any, just let me know. I'll hook you up. And then we're going to get started here. I haven't done anything yet to my hair or to my face, and nothing really to my hair either, because I like to show what, my results are. So I'm gonna go ahead and put some primer on. I'm gonna go ahead with the VFX Pro Camera Ready, the strobe primer, and this is the one that's luminescent here. And I'm also today, I'm gonna put concealer, dark concealer on my nose, and that's the, I've tried it once and I really liked it. So I'm trying to get my nose contoured to where I like it. And I've been doing different things. And so this is gonna be a new trick today for me on here to show you guys, so. Let me know if you're watching, give me some love. Got so much going on with pharmacy here, guys. We have so many gift bundles and stocking stuffers. If you're still kind of undecided or not done shopping, let me know. Take a look at my page, my beauty page, because I put a lot of, I posted a lot there about what we've got. And again, this is the strobe primer, and it's got a luminescent hue to it. Kind of looks purple to me, but I love it. Kind of pokes through or peeks through your foundation. And it should definitely dry before you put your foundation on. So that leaves me time to go around my eyebrows and put some highlighter around there. And again, I have microbladed brows, so I like what this look does. You can see some of my red skin peeking through when my makeup is done, if I don't highlight my brows or put a little bit of, you know, concealer around them. And so this helps prevent that. Pretty simple. I'm gonna have to start filling them in here soon because it'll be a year in January since I had them done. And it's semi-permanent, so it slowly fades away. I think I'm gonna let them go for a little while because last January when I had them done, when I went in for my touch-up, I asked for, you know, thicker brows, and boy, I really got them thicker. And at first it was shocking, but, you know, again, they look great now. But I don't know that I want to get them that thick again, so I'm going to kind of let it fade a little bit before I do it again. But ain't nothing like microbladed brows. Amazing. Wake up in the morning with eyebrows, you know. Many years I woke up with nothing there, but blonde hair that you couldn't see. So, it's wonderful. All right, let's go in today with the CC cream. Let me see here. I'm gonna just paint it on, and we're gonna brush it on with my new brush. Got some new brushes here. A pharmacy has a professional a set of brushes. Again, I think they're $35. Amazing, guys, you gotta get them. Go on to my site and take a peek. Or again, I pasted my link below. So that's a great gift. They have two different brush sets. And the professional one was sold out, and it just came back in last week, so it'll sell out again. Anyway, if you need a good set of brushes, check it out. Again, when you kind of, you know, paint on the foundation, the warmth of your body temperature helps it melt into your skin. And I found a way better application with doing that. So that's what my practice has been here lately. I am gonna go in with another brush and blend. So many tricks. Whatever works for you is what you should do. And I have a lot of pores, large pores, and a lot of them. So I really want, you know, again, that I don't want to have any little holes on my face. So, and I'm just going to push the product into my skin with this brush. Alexa, volume 1.5. And the color that I use in the CC cream is light. I am pretty darn milky white, but I have a pink undertone. And I will use some contour to give myself some color back, put color back into my skin. Again, I'm just pushing this in. Stifling. here we go. Alexa, volume 2. Now I can't even hear that. Gotta have my music. Especially when I've got caffeine jitters. I'm playing some 90s music. And just blending real good, guys. I haven't been on. I said I was gonna come on Friday, but I got a migraine, so woke up with a crappy migraine. That's why I'm dizzy today. Still have a little bit of it. Kind of ebbs and flows, but horrible. If you have migraines, you know what I mean. Okay. So again, you can see that luminous product kind of peeking through. And where is, let me go ahead and put some, I'm gonna dampen this beauty blender and then I'm gonna take the excess off. With a damp beauty blender, of course. And this one isn't a name brand beauty blender. It's just one that I got off of Amazon. But it does, again, help with the finish and picks up any extra product, like streaking. It doesn't work for me when I use it to apply the makeup. I need a brush. But it does work when you go to, you know, again, finish the look, finish the foundation anyway. Okay. And, alrighty. So again, foundation on. Let's go ahead with contour. Decisions again. We have a, contour stick, and I'm gonna start up here today. And this is kind of a brownish, you know, dark brown contour stick. You could use a bronzer that's more, you know, orangey. But today we'll do this. This works just fine for me. Alexa, next song. And again, that defines my jawline. We're gonna do this dark concealer on my nose today. And that's different. I haven't done that before for you guys, so. And I'm just kind of blending in the contour. Given me some color back. You know, if you're watching, guys, give me some hearts. Hearts will help. Facebook will show my video more with some love. And if you'd like to share, again, I'll get more love too. I'm gonna start doing giveaways for liking and sharing. I got some, a lot of extras over Black Friday, and I'd love to share those with you. And we're gonna start doing that real soon here. I just gotta get it together, figure out what I'm gonna give away and kind of what the criteria is for that. Okay, so again, contour on the cheekbones. We wanna kind of go upward. We don't wanna go down. We want our face, you know, again, over when we age, gravity pulls everything down. So we want to bring everything up. And again, just kind of blending in under here. We have Pharmacy launched 4 new palettes on December 1st, and one of them was a huge surprise. They also launched the 24 karat gold glam lipstick set. I'm gonna use the purple from that today. They launched a palette that goes with that. Those are like seasonal, so they're not gonna be permanent. So if you guys like what you see, get on there and buy it, because again, it's not a permanent color, it's just seasonal. So all right, well, let's go for this. Let me get my brush out first. Okay, make sure I got that. I got some new brushes too, so I didn't get the pharmacy one. I've been wanting it and waiting, but I couldn't wait no longer, so I got some other brushes, and it's fine. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is kind of draw again with the pharmacy full coverage concealer. This is called Deep Sand.
Hello?
Hello. Reese is here. Reese is joining in. Reese and the dogs. And again, I'm shaky today. Jittery. And I have this bulbous nose. And so I want that to be smaller. And that's why I'm doing this. And this is not the final look, guys. It's just part of the process. Okay. Go ahead and just kind of blend. It does look dark, I agree, but we'll blend it. And it'll be good. I haven't done my makeup since Thursday, so I had a freaking migraine, and yeah, so. And today I'm dizzy and jittery. How about that? Decided I was gonna take a ketone drink, which I did, that has caffeine. It's charged with caffeine, so. And again, that looks pretty dark. We'll lighten it up though. Can you get something, Reese?
No.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Are we gonna have a dog fest again and a child fest? Because the dogs now are playing. And they're knocking my stuff around. Crazy dogs. Different brush now, and we're just blending it out. It's dark. That's for sure, but I want this nose to be smaller. And let's go ahead and take some of that off. Really dark, but we're good. It's a process. We'll get through it. Right, where did that brush go? You guys can see my dogs in the background. Sorry, they just get a little crazy. What do I do with it? I really need contact lenses so I can see what on earth I'm doing. It really sucks to be blind as a bat. Honestly, sucks. I used to wear contacts, but it's been years, and the last time I tried to get them, probably it was before Riley was born. They couldn't fit me with them because I have a astigmatism and I need a toric lens. Anybody knows what a toric lens is? And gosh, I must have went back 4 or 5 times. Okay, you gotta wait a minute or go get.
You said you make burritos.
Well, I'm not making a burrito right now, so, but you can.
You said you made a burrito in the freezer.
Yeah, you just put it in the microwave for 1 minute and 10 seconds. Okay? On a plate. You'll be good. But don't eat it right away. And it's going to be hot. Okay, love you. Let me know if you need any help. Yeah, 1 minute. Just put it on for 70 seconds. But it has to cool off. So don't bite into it. Alright guys, almost done here. I think I did too much brown on here, but we're good. It just takes a little bit longer to blend it out. And I'm just kind of doing a little of this and a little bit of that. I think that has makeup on it. Dog. Yes, I try. Next time I'm just going to put drops instead of drawing the line because it's pretty dang dark, but we're good. Glad the sun's shining today and it's not raining. Gonna stick with that for now. Now we're gonna go ahead and put some concealer under my eye. And again, we want to brighten under the eyes. Today's Monday.
No, the day.
I think it's the 7th. It could be the 8th, though. I'm not sure. Your phone will say what the date is. And again, some may put their eyeshadow on before their foundation, but I've just always done it this way, foundation first and then the shadow. But again, you do you, whatever works for you. So again, it's bright on that side. And we're gonna go in on the other side now. Seriously, dogs? I'm surprised that they're still here. Because Reese is going down. Oh, that's why Reese is still here. And again, we're going to put this gorgeous purple on. I'm going to use a new palette, the Wanderlust palette. It's got some purple in it. And again, just kind of brushing this foundation or this concealer in this brush, bringing it up. Because again, we want our look, our face to be, you know, again, not saggy. So this will give the illusion of, you know, again, high cheekbones and height versus sagging down. Again, you know, make things appear smaller, which is the effect that I want for my nose. But now I'm going to come in and just make sure everything is nice and smooth. Okay, and then let's go ahead while we're at it. Hey Trina, hey David. Just gonna put a little bit up here. We want to highlight that a bit on our nose. And a little bit on our chin. And again, just kind of blending that in. We want to keep this area brightened as well. Okay. Now we're going to set. So I have a new baking brush, not that one. Where is it? There we go. Nope, that isn't. Here it is. Okay, so this one is kind of angled, so I'm gonna bake under here. And I'm using just a loose powder, loose setting powder. Ooh, that's a lot. Good heavens. And again, I'm putting a setting powder on here to set the makeup. And I'm putting a lot under my eyes in case there's fallout from the eyeshadow. Then I can just kind of brush it away. That's my rationale anyway. And again, just kind of setting the makeup. So it lasts longer. I have oily skin, so my oil will peek through pretty quick here. A couple hours, I'll be a little bit shiny, and then I can blot and throughout the day, but I don't usually add anything on my face unless I'm like going out, so. Then I may blot and add more powder. So, all right, what is next here? Let me go ahead and show you the Wanderlust palette, new palette. Just launched on December 1st. And again, we're gonna go in with this cupcake color and then just kind of around there. in, guys. And I'm just using the base color right now. I'm gonna just kind of set my eyeshadow a bit more. And this doesn't really, it's kind of like a flesh tone. It doesn't have any color, but it's kind of like a primer. Alexa, volume 2. And again, just the base right now. And again, come back and come and look at the comments afterward if you can't watch the whole thing, which is long. So, but I'm gonna go ahead and take some the final look. That's what I call it, and just paste that into the comments so you can see what ultimately my look looks like. Okay, let's see here. So we're gonna come in with Noble, which is this one here, and it's a matte color. See that it's there just a wee bit. I don't really see any fallout. The darker your skin, the easier it is to see these kind of these, you know, matte nude colors per se. And I am just white as a ghost, so. You know how you're doing. Give me some love, guys. If you have any questions, let me know. Again, this is a brand new palette I'm using. And if you're just stopping by, make sure you come and see my final look. So, see how I've transformed. I have hooded eyelids, so I don't want to come down. My goal is to kind of keep this upward, if that makes sense. to keep my lids from looking so droopy. They tend to cover my lower lids. I can make it to where you can see my lower lids a little bit better, which is what I'm gonna do today. Okay. Now we're gonna go in. Let me put some lip conditioner on. My lips are dry now. Let's go in with another color here. Trying to figure out. I'm gonna go in with a little bit of blue because I've got a little bit here in my outfit there, so. And this is called Vintage. And I'm just gonna kind of just do a little bit right here. And I'm gonna come over and do it on this side. I'm gonna come in and get this color Cupcake on. And this is the, it's purple shimmer. It's called Cupcake here. So that's what we're gonna use. And I think I'm gonna end up putting some setting spray on the brush and then applying it. But let's see what it looks like without any, without a wet brush. Yeah, I'm gonna need to put some setting spray on there. Okay. I'm just so darn light. I need a little help. Okay. And I could have done a cut crease. And you can see that coming out here. I'm gonna do big bold lips, so I don't want a huge amount of, you know, blingy eyeshadow when I'm gonna do some big lips. But if we had a cut crease going, it would be much, much louder for me. And if I wasn't so white, it would be louder as well. I like this color, it's really pretty. And you can definitely see that. And this is called foiling. When you, you know, when you wet your, I was going to say moist, but that's kind of a yucky word, especially in the nursing field. I wet the brush a little bit so that it's a little bit wet. And again, it's called foiling. So, very pretty. We're gonna go to the other side. And this again is not the finished look, not at all. And I'm not going for heavy duty shadow because I'm gonna have some big purple lips. I don't know about big, but some bold lips. And again, this color is called Cupcake. Very pretty. Just kind of foiling it.
I want a burrito.
Okay, well, if you want to wait for me, I'll be a little bit. Otherwise, you can just put it in the microwave.
I haven't ate.
Did you cook it in the microwave for 1 minute?
No, I went to the bathroom.
Oh, okay. So just get a paper plate and wrap it up in a paper towel, just like a corn dog, and then do it for 70 seconds. Okay, just like you would a corn dog. That makes sense? Wrap a paper towel around it. Put it on a paper plate. And then, you got it? You can leave, well, yeah, you can leave it in a wrapper, take it out. I don't know if it has a wrapper on it, does it? Okay, if whatever you want to do, if you take it out of the wrapper, wrap it around, wrap a paper towel around it.
So what do I do? I put it on plate.
Uh-huh.
Take it out of the wrapper and put a towel around
paper
it.
Paper towel, 70 seconds in the microwave. You got it.
And then I take it out and eat it.
Yep. Reese is learning to be independent. And it's not cooking, it's just putting it in the microwave. A frozen burrito. A frozen burrito. Okay. Alexa, next song. Make sure I have enough color there, of course. Next time I'll try this as a cut crease. So this purple pops. We are going to stop at that point, and then we're going to go in and do a little bit more work because we are far from done. Let's go in with this divine color here. A little bit over. Alexa, next song. Alexa, stop. Alexa, play music.
Here's a station you might like. My soundtrack, Amazon Music.
How do you feel? I'm just coming over about halfway. And this weekend. And this, I've got some fallout with the darker color there. All right, let's see here. A little bit more of that noble color right in here. And then we're gonna blend, so. Keep that pistol in the drawer. All right, now I'm just going to take a fluffy brush and blend. I'm going to get rid of this fallout here. One of the reasons why I, again, set underneath my eyes or bake. And I'm just going to soften this up, kind of blend. Mm-hmm. It's patchy. It's patchy. I'm going to put a little bit more dark on the outer area there because it looks patchy. And again, just kind of blending this, softening it. I didn't want a big eye today. Okay. Need a smaller little brush here. Let's come in with this little brush. It's patchy right there, so. And I want to blend that purple. I'm right where I want to be. Alexa, next song. Facebook's not gonna like that song. Gonna say I'm breaking the rules. Okay. So I'm looking a little patchy right here. You never know what you're gonna get, you know? When you do your shadow, you know what color you want to use, and you think you're gonna get this look, and you get that look. As long as it looks decent, we'll take it. This is where it's a little patchy, guys. Before you, what if I told you? Coming, queen. All right, and again, I'm going to bring my eyes upward because we don't want them going down. We want to bring everything up. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and blend again. Blend, blend, blend. Just kind of softening it. Hey, homecoming queen. All right. Good deal, good deal. It takes a little work. But we're just softening at this point. And I'm just kind of dipping into my little sponge there to take the product off because I don't want to bring that darker color over. Okay, pretty. I like it. But a little bit more right here. Yeah, let me just bring that over a little bit. What you been looking for? And I'm just going in with my finger now, giving that a little bit more color. Okay. Awesome. All right, so I like the look. Let's go ahead with eyeliner. Let's see. Okay, so I have a purple liner, but no, I'll save that for bottom maybe. Let's just go in with brown color. With this just plain brown, and I'm just gonna sharpen it here. Hope you're happy now. Happy now. Okay, so again, this is just a pharmacy eye pencil. Number 5, Pharmacy is European, so they name, they do a lot of numbering for their colors, for their system. So, again, just a little bit on the softer side. And again, I don't want a real defined line. So I want to, again, my lips to be more obvious than my eyes here. I have this wonderful purple. Go ahead. It's not a pharmacy purple because it's pretty loud. So I'm going to use that I'm going to tight line this real quick with a blue. I do have some blue in my look today, so I'm gonna go ahead and, hey, talking to my fan. Must have set the timer. Alexa, volume 2. In my eyes here. That was 7 seconds ago. And I'm gonna add some purple. So just a little pop of purple in there. So again, that purple is amazing for this look. Nobody. What I thought I'd do is put a little bit of that cupcake underneath here, but it's not gonna show because I'm too darn light. And I've been on here too long to do any glitter. I'm gonna try some glitter, but been here too long. I'm gonna drag this out, so. I'm just combing through. Go ahead and powder up before we do the mascara and the blush here. Let's use the Face Perfecting Powder. Again, I use the color number one. Usually I'm a number one in everything. Which is the lightest. And see, I can come up with that and just kind of straighten that up a little bit. Some like to do that with concealer. or clean it up with like a makeup wipe if they don't have their foundation on, but I'm good. I like it this way. And I'm gonna put this powder over my nose, over those dark lines. You're gonna see the lines, and they're probably a little darker than I want today, but that's okay. I think I, next time I'll just put little dots there instead of drawing, you know, again down with that dark concealer, because it's definitely dark. So, but again, hopefully my nose appears a little bit smaller. That was my goal, so. Just putting a little powder here. And I'm gonna clean up my brows again. Just taking any excess product that got on my brows off. A little bit different. More on this one. And let's go ahead and put a little bit of brow gel on there. This is clear, and it's eyebrow gel. And if you have the lash extensions, this is amazing. Women are using that for their lash extensions, again, to take the product off the top and also to kind of recomb them, you know, each day. I don't have them, and I don't know what they feel like, so, but I know that they will tend to get a little bit out of hand and not straight. This helps to kind of keep them straight there, and it's not a real big hold at all. That's why they're using it. Amazing. So I do have a boatload of brows here that you cannot see because we are thin and fine and blonde, but they're there. And so can see the product on them. I just wish that they were more, they weren't sparse or they were thicker so that I could actually use them in my makeup look, but it's all good. We're never happy with what we have. We got straight hair, we want curly hair. We've got curly hair, we want straight hair. I'm light-skinned. I wish I was darker so that I had some color and I didn't burn. But it's all good. So, let's go in with Zen today. I just opened this as my second one. Amazing. This is $8.90 and this, it lengthens. It pulls your lashes out because the wand has one end, one side of the wand is thinner, shorter. So you're able to pull your lashes out, and the other side of the wand has got longer bristles. So the silicone wand, and it's just amazing. So I started with the 3D effect, a mascara. It's a little bit more costly, but, this is the cheapest one we have, and it's one of my favorites. I also like the new one, the double lash extend, and maybe I'll put the volumizing on here so I can show you guys That one is a two wand system, a two wand mascara. But look at this, all right, just from the cheapest mascara we have, $8.90. And this doesn't budge, it doesn't transfer up onto your hooded eyelid, onto mine anyway, that hangs over. And again, I'm just kind of combing. I've been using the Lash and Brow Serum. It's, again, has Capixel in it, the same as the Garlic Capixel shampoo and conditioner mask. It has the same chemical in there for hair growth. And I'm noticing that my lashes are really healthy and longer and stronger. And again, I'm just turning and lengthening. Okay, and again, pretty uniform. I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side, and then we will give it another coat. Lengthening, kind of rolling. Forgot to turn my other light on here. Okay, maybe that's a little bit better. And again, that lash serum is really helping me, helping my lashes to grow and be stronger. And I have a bundle with the lash serum, the new launched Double Lash Extend mascara, and an eyeliner for $34.90. It's a $20 savings if you bought the products separately. Alexa, next song. So again, very full lower lashes from using that lash serum. They're healthy and strong. When I wonder if I just adding a little bit more product on here. You went back, if you went back and looked at my pictures at my lashes a year ago, you would see they were much shorter and less full because I've been using the lash serum. And again, this is the amazing mascara, the Zen mascara. Amazing wand. So again, amazeballs, guys. Oh, baby, I need you. This also gives me the double lash effect. Zen. Amazing. Alright, let's go for dark berry on the blush today.
Ooh, there goes nothing.
Alexa, next song. Okay. put a little bit of this bronzer on to give me some color. It's one of the good ones. Locking up the He's one of the good ones. Alrighty. Now we're going for that wonderful lipstick here. My hair's. Okay. Just find a brush that I want to use. One of the good ones. Alright. Like here. Let me just go ahead and put a little bit more of the lip conditioner on. I'm going to show you the amazing kit here in just a bit. Alright. I'm going to line with a purple color. He's one of the good ones. All righty, and again, this is number 226 in the lip liner. We'll check this out. So again, this is the 24 karat gold glam lipstick set. It's a limited edition, so again, it's seasonal. These are amazing colors. I'm going to use the purple from this set today. There's also a blingy a palette, an eyeshadow palette, and I used the Wonderlust palette today because it has that purple that I wanted to use, and the palette that goes with this has more of the kind of the golds and rust and black. So again, for like a New Year's Eve, New Year's party, etc. I used that on Thursday on my eyes, and I used the red lipstick from there. And so again, this is my shadow from the Wonderlust palette, or Wanderlust. And again, here is the purple color. So this color has some gold shimmer to it. It's easier to see like in the daylight, but there is a gold shimmer to it. And here we go. It's already beautiful. I wore purple, the color Confident, the other day, and this is really purple. That one is more of a really deep, darker purple, but this is purple. Hey, amazing. I did use the lip conditioner before this. And that did help with the application. But I'm gonna kind of go through it. I was watching one of our other wonderful ladies here who had this trick. And with the makeup brush there, it just really helped to smooth it out, make it look more perfect. And again, this is Richie Purple. So go ahead. Now you can see the gold since I've used it. You can see the gold shimmer in it. And I got no upper lip, so really hard to, you know, again, do my lips. And I can see the gold flecks in it. And this is a very purple, like a grape purple. It's amazing. So again, this lipstick kit or bundle, it comes with three lipsticks in these gorgeous pharmacy containers. And again, the theme is 24 karat gold glam. And again, three colors. You'll have to come back to see the others. I've already worn the red, but amazing. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. This is $49.95 for this. What a great gift it would make as well. So again, I'm going to go ahead and take some pictures and post them if you're curious about the product. You want to get a discount. I can give you information on that. Alright, so the final look. I like it. It's pretty. Anyway, thanks for coming on here. Give me some love. Let me know what you think. And I hope you have a great rest of your Monday. Take care. Ciao.